Space Marines are genetically enhanced superhuman warriors who defend mankind against the horrors of a hostile galaxy in the grim darkness of the 41st millennium. The Space Marine heroes are all fantastically detailed miniatures, and once you've built yours, you might want to paint it. And if you do and you've never painted a Citadel miniature before, then this is the video for you, because we're going to walk you through step by step the entire process of painting a Citadel miniature. We're going to be using Brother Castor for our example, but no matter which Space Marine hero you're painting, by following this method through, you'll be able to paint your miniature too. So, let's get started. Whenever you're painting a Citadel miniature, the first thing that you need to do is set up your painting area. You need to put something down to protect the work surface that you're painting on, and you can see here I have a cutting mat for that purpose. You will also need to get together all the paints that you're going to use. You'll need a palette as well to get your paints ready on, which you'll see shortly. You'll need some tissue to dry your brushes off on, and of course you need the brushes themselves. And finally, you'll need some clean water to wash your brushes in. Now, before you start putting any paint onto the miniature, the first thing you need to do is prime it with some Citadel spray paint to help that paint stick to the plastic. There's lots of colours available, but for our Space Marine heroes, well, they're mostly blue, so Macragge blue is the perfect colour for this. Now, you need to find a way of handling the miniatures whilst you spray them, and there's loads of ways of doing this, but the one I find that I like the most is to get hold of an old stick like I've got here, and then put some double-sided tape onto it. So, I'm going to put some on here now. There we go. And then just tear it off at the end. And then, here comes the fiddly bit, we now just need to get the backing off the tape. So let's do that now. And there we go. And then we're ready to put our Space Marine onto the tape. So, you just need to securely put him here, and you can see with him on there like that, I can now easily move this around and get to all the details of our miniature. So with that done, it's time to go outside and spray him. Once you're outside, set up an empty box on its side to catch the excess spray. Give the can a really good shake. Hold the can about 30 centimeters away from the miniature and start spraying in short bursts. Move the model around on the stick to make sure you can get to all the detail, but be careful not to get carried away putting on too much paint. You don't want to clog any of the detail. Be sure not to spray in windy conditions, and also don't spray when it's raining or very cold either. Once you finish spraying, give your miniature about 10 minutes to dry. Now that we've undercoated our Space Marine hero, we're ready to start painting him. And the first kind of paint we're going to apply to our miniature is called a shade paint. And this will appear very runny and very thin, but it's designed to run into all the recessed detail on your miniature and really give it some depth by helping that detail to stand out. The paint is called non-oil, and when you're using these paints, it's always a good idea to make sure the lid's firmly closed and you give them a really good shake before you use them. And the size brush you want to apply this with is called a medium shade brush. It's the ideal kind of size for this sort of thing. And what I recommend you do here is use a palette. You want to load up your brush with some of this paint and then put it onto your palette here like this, and you can see just how runny it is there. Build up a good puddle like this because having it on the palette allows you to control exactly how much you're applying at once. This way you can be sure not to be putting on too much or too little. So once you've got some on your palette like this, load your brush up, and when you're ready, all you've got to do is start painting it onto your miniature. And as you apply it, you'll see it'll run into all that detail and just help give it a bit more definition. So paint it all over your model now. Bear in mind, because it's thin, it will tend to run towards the bottom of your miniature. So if you see it doing that, just move away the excess paint with your brush. And once you've painted it all over, give it about an hour to dry. As you apply the shade, you want to be sure to cover all the armour that's going to finish blue. Don't worry about other details just yet, for example the gun or some features on the backpack, because we will apply other colours to those later on. Now that the non-oil is completely dry, you can see it's settled nicely in the recess detail and helped define it, but it has darkened down the armour a little bit, so what we're going to do now is apply some more Macragge blue, but this time in base paint form. What a base paint is a paint with quite a lot of pigment in it, so it gives a very strong coverage very quickly. And we're going to be applying this using a medium layer brush, and we're going to be careful about where exactly we apply it. So, you do need to use a palette here to help with this, so get some of that paint onto your palette, but this time add a small amount of water to the mix. You don't need very much, just a little bit like this, but doing this just helps thin the paint down so it goes a little bit further and dries smoother as well. So once you've got it about like this, you're ready to start applying it. And what you want to do is make sure you don't have too much paint on your brush. You got a good tip there. And what you do is look for areas where the shade has settled and, well, avoid them. So for example, if we look at the arm here, I'd paint this part on the elbow, but the shade has settled just there as it goes to the forearm. So I'd leave that part and then start painting on the other side of it, just like this. And you carry on doing this across all of the blue armour. With that done, the blue's brighter again, and we've still got all that detail standing out nicely from the shading. And with that done, we can now start using the next colour, which is going to be for all the silver details. The paint is another base paint, and it's called Lead Belcher. And again, we're going to be applying it using a medium layer brush. And as before, you must make use of a palette here, because we're doing much more detailed stuff now. So, thin your paint down with a little bit of water, until you get to about that point, so it's nice and smooth, and then you're ready to start picking out these details. The first one that we're going to paint is these silver details on the bolt gun just here. And some of the bolt gun will be black later on, but don't worry about that just yet. We will neaten it up as we go. Then we need to paint the grenade just down here. And there's some detail up around the head to paint as well. Finally, we have some silver details to paint on the backpack as well. Now that we've finished painting in all that silver, we're ready to move on to our next paint, which is going to be for all the black details. So the colour we're going to use now is a Baden Black, which is another base paint, and we're going to be applying it to begin with a medium layer brush, but we will need the medium shade brush later as well. Now, as before, use your palette to get your paint thinned down, nice and ready, and you want it to about this point here. And then make sure your brush isn't overloaded, because we've got quite a few small details now to paint. The first one we're going to begin with is going to be the casing of the bolt gun. Then we need to paint the hair. And then we have some leather pouches to paint as well. Then look closely at the model for any little cables that you can find, such as this one just here. And when you're painting around this area too, be sure to paint underneath the shoulder pads too. With that done, we now need to start painting all the joints and the armour. Be as neat as you can around here as you paint in between all those blue panels. Once you've reached this point, you're now ready to change your brush because we've got some details on the base that we need to paint as well. So, now going to the medium shade brush, and once you've got this loaded up as well, we're going to start painting all these parts between the cracks in the concrete. And finally, paint the rim of the base as well. If you can still see some of that blue showing through, just let the first coat dry, then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. Now that we've finished painting all the black details, we're ready to start painting in all the gold details. And for this, we're going to use another base paint, and this one's called Balthazar Gold. We're going to be using the medium layer brush again for this, because a lot of these details are very small, so we want lots of control here. So, again, a great way to help doing this is to thin your paint down on your palette, so it's nice and smooth. And this way you've got lots of control over it. And all we've got to do is start picking out these details. Now they tend to be more decorative things, so a great example of this is this eagle we've got on the side of the bolt gun just here. We also have an eagle on the chest plate, and this one can be a little bit tricky to get to, so just take your time and be as neat as you can. We now have the trim on the shoulder pads, and you can pick these out by just using the side of your brush and just lightly running it along the raised detail. Another decorative detail to paint is this skull on the backpack just here. I'm also going to paint the purity seal down here with gold. And finally, remember to look at the base to pick out any gold details here too. We've got these eagle designs and also the bullet casings just here as well. We're now finished painting with the gold, and we're ready to start painting in some grey details onto the base of our miniature. We're going to be using Mechanica Standard Grey for this, and we're using the medium layer brush once more. And as before, use your palette to get your paint ready, only this time you want to apply just a little bit more than you have been doing, because this detail is quite large. So once your paint is ready, load up your brush, and then it's time to start painting these parts. And you're looking at the concrete on here and the skull as well. And the trick here is, as you're applying this, just be really careful about those gold details whenever you get close to them. Once we've finished with Mechanica Standard Grey, we're ready to move on to painting the skin if you've decided to build your Space Marine hero without the helmet on. For this, we need Bugman's Glow, and we're going to be applying it again with the medium layer brush, because this is quite an intricate bit of detail here, we need to be careful. So remember to use your palette to get your paint ready so it's nice and smooth and flowing really easily. And then once you've done that, all you've got to do is start picking out the flesh, being careful of all the hair and also the metal details around. When you're applying this colour, if you do find that blue paint still showing through, just let this first coat dry, then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way. Now that we've finished painting the skin, we just have one more step left, and that is to go back to normal oil, because we're going to reapply it, but this time just to a very few parts. So we're going to be using the medium layer brush to apply it now, because we don't need as much, and what you want to do is again use your palette to control exactly how much you have in your brush at once. And what we want to do here is paint over all the silver details, and also the concrete on the base. I'm going to start just up here with the silver on the bulb gun. Once you've finished applying the Nuln oil, give your miniature about 30 minutes to dry. Now that the Nuln oil is completely dry, Brother Castor is complete and ready to join his brothers on the field of battle. So remember, whenever you're painting a Space Marine hero, always use a palette to thin down your paints with a small amount of water, because doing so ensures that they'll go a little bit further and also dry smoother as well. Always remember to be as neat as you can as you apply the paint, and if you can see any of the original colour showing through the colour that you're painting, just apply a second thin coat once the first one's dry to ensure you get a good, smooth, even coverage. So there you go, that's really all you need to know to paint your Space Marine heroes. And remember, no matter which Space Marine hero you're painting, you can do so by following along with the methods we've shown in this video. We hope you have fun painting your Space Marine hero, and we'll see you again soon.